Welcome to Sew Very Easy. My name is Laura. And do you buy quilting fabric just because you like the look of the fabric? Oh, I do it all the time. And then when I get home, I have to design a quilt to go with the fabric because I didn't buy the fabric to go with the quilt. Let me show you how I do it. This is going to work if you have bought the fabric from the same line, or if you want to use up a bunch of leftover fabrics. I use a computer system, and it's EQ7. Now, what they've done is they've come out with a mini version of EQ7, and it's perfect to use up the scraps and make some quick patterns. Even before I get to the computer program, I choose my fabric, regardless if it's a line that I've bought or I want to use the scrap fabrics. I choose the pile of fabric that I want. I will buy basic colors, beiges, blacks. I always like to have a polka dot in, and white. I find that I'm going to be able to pull from this pile into this pile if I need it. So this is always a good backup to have. You need to decide on the fabric you're going to use. You're also going to need how much fabric you have of each. And it's really easy if you've bought already the fabric, you know you've bought a yard of each. But if you want to do a quilt with scrap fabric and leftover, you can still use the same method. Both of them are going to work the same. With the scrap fabric and the new fabric, I divide my piles into three. The first thing I choose is the focal fabric that I want to use. And then I make two piles, a dark pile and a light pile. I will take all of the darks and put them in one pile, and all of the lights or the mediums in the other. And it doesn't necessarily matter at this point what the colors are. I'm not going to put all the greens together. I just want a contrast. I try to pull in another large piece of fabric, even if I'm just going to use it for sashing or binding, just so that I have it handy. And that's where that extra pile comes in that I like to keep. So I can do this pile here of all the leftovers, or I can do the same thing with the pile that I bought that coordinated together. So I can start adding some blacks and some whites to go with this. I might not use them, but I can add them before I get to the computer. So I'm going to make a dark pile and a medium pile and pull in a solid just in case I need it. Now I just need to know how much I have. If you're using fat quarters, you're going to know that 4 fat quarters equals a yard. Now let's get to the computer. Now EQ7 has 2 different versions, and this is the mini version, which is a great one to start off with, and it's also a great one just to do some basic patterns. You can always upgrade this to the full version if you want. When you open it up, you have different quilt layouts, so you just need to choose a quilt layout. And what I like to do is I start with the very first one, which is a basic block. When I click on that, I'm able to work on that layout. So I've started with the quilt that I've wanted, and I have lots of different ones to choose from. Now I'm going to adjust the layout, and I like to start with 3 blocks by 3 blocks. So I can change it to go 3 blocks by 3 blocks. It's also going to give you the size of what the center is, and at the bottom it gives you the size of the finished quilt. And I always like to have a border, so I'm going to go and put a large border on, and I do like to start with about 3 to 4 inches. When you go to the layout, you're going to be able to change the size of the block. So whatever block you're comfortable with working in is a good size to start with. So right now it's defaulted at 9 inches. That's a really nice size block. You can change the block after. So I'll go to the design the quilt. I'm going to go up into the library and find block library. And it's going to give me lots of choices for blocks. From there, I can choose any of these designs, and you're going to add them to a sketchbook. I like to start with a simple 9 patch. I'm going to add it to the sketchbook. Let's try a monkey wrench, put that into the sketchbook. And you can go to any of the other files and just add blocks that you like into the sketchbook. I'm going to be able to close this and they show up in the sketchbook. There's a little button at the side that you are going to be able to set the blocks into the quilt. But before I do that, I take all of my blocks and I change them to black and white or gray and white. So give a right click, select coloring, and you can see you have a choice between nothing, gray and white, or the actual color. Because none of these colors are going to match, I'm going to do them all in the gray. So now the theme is the same, and I have the colors already light and medium to start with. Now I'm just going to be able to click onto one block and add it to wherever I want. If you decide you don't want that block there, you can always use the back button. I'm going to take the birds in the air and I'm going to put them in the four corners. I'm going to take the monkey wrench and put it in the four other areas. And then maybe take this patch and put it right in the center. So I've used up all of my spots. And there's a button on the side that will rotate. And that's a great button. So I'm going to take the birds in the air and rotate them. So I have a layout that I like. I can save it, and up here there's a little button that says Add to Sketchbook. I just save it because I want to start with this. Let's change the corners. Just use that rotate button. Let's put all of the birds in the air in the center. Now you can see a little bit of a star or a wheel formation. From here, we can start to add colors. There's a little paintbrush in the corner. Click on the paintbrush and you're going to have a menu come up. It's going to have a bunch of different fabrics. It's also going to have a tab that says colors. I like to start with my colors and that will give me an idea of what I want. And this is where working with the scraps work, because if I have green, I have five different greens, I will still be able to use those as one color green. So I have the turquoise that I'm going to start with first. And I'm just going to color some of the fabrics in turquoise. The next is going to be a black. So I'll get to my black and I'll just fill in a couple of the spots with the black. And from here you can continue coloring in different blocks as you go along. And just play with your standard colors as you go along. When I've come up with a design that I like, I want to check and make sure that I have enough fabric. So I go up to the top where there's a little printer icon, and the drop-down menu says Fabric Yardage. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to preview it. I'm not going to print it. I just want to preview it. What it does is it pulls up the fabrics that I've used and how much. So far, I know that I'm going to have enough material in my stash, but I have a little bit more than what is required here. So I'm going to make the blocks a little bit bigger. I'm going to go back in and now see how much fabric I'm going to need. And if you have enough fabric and you're happy with the quilt, you're done. The first thing I do like to do is save it. Now it's a matter of making the quilt and printing out the pattern. I go into my print button and I do like to print out the quilt. And I've printed out the quilt in black and white. Two reasons. Number one, the colors here might not be the exact colors that you have. So it's good just to see the values, not so much the colors. Now that you've seen it in a gray value, it might give you a whole new idea. The next thing that I'm going to want to print out is the fabric that I'm going to need. And I've printed it also in the grayscale. Now I know I used three blocks, so I need to print three blocks out of this. If you go into your little arrow up at the top, click onto one of the blocks, you'll be able to have an outline of the block. It's outlined in green. you'll be able to go then up to the print button, and I'm going to print it into a rotary cutting design. And when I print it out in the grayscale, I can still see the different colors. I know that I have 4 corner blocks that need to be printed out. The center block is also going to need to be printed. Now I have a pattern that's going to go with the fabric. I can do the same thing with the scraps. It would really be fun to see what this would look like in another color variation. Let's go into the colors and give it a try. So now you can take your fabric and design a quilt to go with your fabric, not the fabric to go with the quilt. Make sure you save it. And the other thing I do is I make sure that I label my colors on this page. Either take a piece of the fabric and cut a little swatch off and put it right along those edges so that in a couple of weeks when you go to do this pattern, you will know what colors you had in mind. You can spend a lot of time designing many, many different quilts. You can take the one pattern, and from the one pattern alone, you can design many, many quilts. And if you're not sure of the layout, there is a little button that can change the layout for you in different ways. The button that looks like 4 quilt squares together, if you click on that and then just click anywhere in the block, it's going to change the layout. And it is the same blocks, just a different layout of the blocks. I've only scratched the surface on what the program is capable of doing. It takes the guesswork out of the sizes, and it takes the guesswork out of how much fabric you're going to need. EQ is a lot of fun to play with. There are a lot of tutorials on how to use this, and there's a help button built right in, so you can search for whatever you need. I'll put a link in the description to EQ7 and the EQMini, which I used here. And the great part about this, it doesn't matter where you live, it is downloadable. So if you have a computer, you can download it for a computer and a Mac. There is one thing I am going to warn you about. It is very addicting. It is so much fun. Before you know it, you're going to have all of your fabric designed into a quilt, which means you'll have to go buy more fabric. Thank you for joining me today on Sew Very Easy. Feel free to subscribe, and as always, come on back. Let's see what we're sewing next time in the sewing room. Bye for now. Now, if you'd like a chance to win this EQ Mini version, be sure to put a comment in the comment section of today's video on what you liked about today's video. And randomly, someone will win this program. Now be sure to get your comment in before November 1st, 2016. And this is just in time for Christmas. Now anyone can win this program because it's downloadable. So good luck.